We're celebrating the end of Neighbours. 37 fabulous years it's been. And someone who really ruffled feathers on Ramsay Street was none other than one of our own Studio 10 family members.
Oh, yeah. Ding Dong Starters troublemaker Nance Sluggett.
Let's have a look.
Do you think...
You didn't hire her for a skill or a talent, so what is she doing here?
I could ask you the same thing.
I have more right to be a cover model than you have to be behind that counter.
Well, you're in luck, because Women's Weekly rang and they're doing a special issue on mutton.
Oh, ladies, please!
Gary, I told you, if you feed an alley cat, they won't leave you alone.
Wow, this is good for ageing skin. And clingy mothers. Oh. And this is... Scrubber's name Nance.
Oh, that's Nance.
She's not my girlfriend.
I've never been so disrespected in my whole life. Shove your job and you can forget about our deal. I'll make sure Jeremy's out of jail and you can kiss your kneecaps goodbye.
No, please, we can sort this out. No, go!
Oh, the Sluggett.
You're a great actress.
It's fantastic.
Fantastic.
How was it? Did you love playing Nancy?
Oh, I was nervous because I'm for lines.
Well, it's not to remember. You're pumping out, right?
No, we only had one take with that too, with the squirty squirties.
Did you know Colette Mann before you did this? Have you known her for ages?
Colette and I used to be in the... you know, the competitions.
Prisoner? Oh, no, dancing competitions.
When we were this big.
Oh, oh, the aesthetics.
Yes, at Ballarat and everywhere like
my
that.
Goodness.
That's how long we've known each other.
Oh, who won out of you two back in the day?
Oh, I can't remember.
Now, you did get to share the screen with the Susan Kennedy. Tell us about that.
Did she give you any tips? You know Susan Kennedy?
Oh, the lovely lady.
The long, dark hair. She's Dr. Carl's wife on the show.
I don't know her.
Yeah. I've got it right.
Who is it?
What was it like, though? Because she's got short hair now. I threw you.
Yeah. She's gorgeous. Sorry, love. She's lovely.
She give you any advice?
Yeah, just keep talking. No, but see, I think this is fabulous because Channel 7 diced this and then Fox picked it up. Didn't they?
Ten
picked it up, and then Fox. It went on to Fox as well when that started, and it's huge in Britain.
Massive.
They love it.
Massive.
They love it. So, and to have 37 years job, Christ. I mean, damn. that's amazing.
But how did they come up with the name Sluggett?
Oh, I don't know, but it suited me.
Did you have any input into your character development? Like, did you get to play with the wardrobe or throw in some of those fabulous lines?
No, kiss your kneecaps goodbye. No, they just say what the Sluggett is.
Right.
She's this middle-aged or very aged. So, it was good fun. I love doing it, but I'm getting more nervous with lines.
Well, it's a lot to remember, but it's such a nice family atmosphere, though.
Oh,
that's what we
lovely.
Keep hearing from the Neighbours set, that they're not just saying goodbye to a show and a set, they're saying goodbye to their families.
It's a family, and I'm dying to know who's coming back to...
It's such a big part of Australian history.
Because it could be anybody. There's been so many people that have become stars after that show.
Yeah.
And do you think it worked so well because it was... real Australia, like suburban Australia. Didn't set it in a police station, didn't set it in a hospital or whatever. It was just Australia. It's been Australia.
I think you're right. Yeah. Gorgeous. They'll be really, really sad on that
day. I know.
And you're going to be there.
Yeah, so we're doing a special week of shows leading up to the big day where we broadcast live from the set. All starts next week. Big farewell for Neighbours. I know. I grew up on it. We moved to Queensland, and the way I got to Queensland, my mum said, we're moving to Queensland like Scott and Charlene. Get in the Sigma. It's a long drive.
And
I said, how long? They said, 10 episodes of Neighbours is halfway.
And the thing is, the show hasn't been down to Melbourne for such a long time.
I know. Well, we haven't been anywhere.
No,
we haven't been able
that'll
to.
Be lovely.
So, what's next for your acting career? Hollywood, you know?
Oh,
who would be your perfect leading man?
Sylvester Stallone.
Sly.
Did he make a suggestion to you once? Or?
Does he do it for you, Sly?
No.
You don't want to be
the
next...
only one I could think of.
You don't want to be in the next Rocky movie, do you?
Oh, no. What movie would I like to be in?
Something romantic.
You did a nice audition for Ghost.
For what? Oh, for Ghost? No, you know,
I thought you pulled that off quite well.
I really would like to have worked, not now because he's too old.
Matt Lenevez?
Clint Eastwood.
Clint Eastwood. Oh.